What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video and happy new year to every single one of you. This is going to be a big year. Today we're going to jump straight into the topic, how to stop comparing yourselves to others financially. Jumping into the new year, I know y'all got a bunch of big goals set, a bunch of resolutions set, and things of that nature that are going to improve your life. Whether your goals are physical, mental, spiritual, relational, or financial, this video is 100% going to help you, because this video is going to help with all of those at once. And if you're new to the channel, welcome. I'm Reggie Bryant. I'm the author of The Wealth Journey, and this channel is all about personal finance and personal growth. How to stop comparing yourselves to others financially is a very big deal, and I'm actually going to start this video with a very quick story. I've always been a highly ambitious person, always wanted to make a lot of money, have nice things, provide for my family, my future family, all that good stuff. Whenever I have kids, whenever I have a wife, any of my family members, my immediate family members have hard times or anything, I'll be able to help them. That's the mindset that I've always had. I just always wanted to be that person that had an abundance of finances, because I grew up seeing a lot of families and even some of my own family struggle with finances. And it was something that it's a pain point that I know a lot of people have. A lot of my friends had growing up, a lot of adults that I came into contact with, they've all had a similar pain point when it came to money, whether it was because of debt, whether it was because of not making enough, not saving enough, not having enough. You get the idea. So naturally, I grew up being very ambitious and always wanted to just do above average in everything, especially when it came to like making money per year. So once I got my first full-time job and everything, I always aimed high. I was always like, I'm not going to hit like the norm of what the, you know, average house income for America is. I want to go out with a full-time job already having above what the average is. And that's exactly what I did. But I never wanted to just stop there. I wanted to keep going, because again, financial abundance isn't just getting above average. Financial abundance is having money coming in no matter what, in excess. That's what I wanted, and that's what I was not going to stop aiming for until I got it. So when you're ambitious, the problem is you look to other people for maybe guidance, for inspiration, and things of that nature. And I didn't just have someone that I could just grab and say, hey, what do you think about this? Hey, how do I make more money here? Like, I didn't really have anyone that I could look up to in that specific way at that time. So what I did was I was hitting up YouTube and I was learning about how to make more money, how to be financially abundant, how to have passive income and things of that nature. And at the time, I really didn't even know what passive income was, but I liked the idea of just having money coming in no matter what. So I just kind of rabbit holed into a bunch of different information. And what I ended up doing was inevitably was going to happen anyway, but what I ended up doing was comparing myself to the people on the other side of the screen. I was looking at all these YouTubepreneurs, you know, these folks who have built pretty big networks and brands on YouTube, and they were reporting that they were making, you know, $10,000 a month, $12,000 a month just off of ad revenue from YouTube. And then they had like a book over here, then they had a course over there, and some of them were like 24, 25 years old. I was 21 at the time, so I'm like, man, this is like really inspiring. So at first, I wasn't comparing myself at all, until I realized how hard my job got, until I realized working even 7 days a week at my job, even with overtime included at my job, didn't even come up to the amount of money that these guys were making that was so-called passive. So I'm thinking to myself, what am I doing wrong? Why did I go to school for 4 freaking years to pursue an engineering degree and then get a job that's not even in the field that I studied for, and then still not make the amount of money that these guys are making off of YouTube? And the comparison trap that I was putting myself in, well, what these guys are doing is easy. All they do is put on a camera and talk to someone, and they say something relatable. They get someone to subscribe. They get a few people to buy their course. They get a few people to buy their book. Now they're getting passive income. First of all, that's not easy at all. But second, I was comparing my life to theirs. Like, I felt like their lives were so much easier because they had money, not really knowing what their financial obligations are, not really knowing what they go through on a day-to-day basis. I just know that compared to the way my life looks through my eyes, there's no way that their life can be any harder. It's got to be easy. They get to wake up when they want to. You know what I'm saying? They're entrepreneurs. They get to do whatever they want to. And some of those assumptions may be true, and some of those assumptions are probably not true at all. But there's no way to know. And that's the whole point of this video. There's no way that you can know. Even if someone appears to be doing better than you, even if someone appears to have a much nicer car than you, a much happier life than you, they may have the Instagram pictures, the pictures of them on vacation or on the beach. You know, they may have just gotten themselves a new house that's very luxurious, that they just built up from the ground. Like, they could have all these things going for them on the surface. From the exterior, it looks like they have all of it. It looks like they have it made. And you can just feel like you're out here struggling, grinding, sweating, bleeding, you know what I'm saying, for a life that does not even come up to half of what the next guy has or the next girl has. And that's a thought process that we've got to stop having, because then that leaves us off of our own track, because that leads us to asking questions like, man, what do you do for a living? How much money do you make? How do I get the same results as you? There's nothing wrong with having a curiosity for these things, but we ask these questions almost as if we're going to stop everything that we've done and everything that we've worked for to drop it and just go back to school and get the exact same degree that they got and then go into the same exact field that they're in. Like, that's not always feasible, and it doesn't mean you'll get the same results. They may just be really good at what you do, but if you focus on one thing, if you focus on getting really good at something, it's going to be pretty hard to fail. It may take a while to build what you want, but the thing is, it's going to take a while anyway. If you stop what you're doing, you go back to school, right? You take 4 years, 6 years, 8 years, depending on which field you're going into and which degree that you're going for, it could take you a long time. Wanting the same exact types of cars that other people have, it's like, do you really want them? Because there were so many times where I thought I wanted things that I really didn't even want for myself, but I saw someone else have them and I just thought that I wanted them. I thought I wanted a Mercedes when I was 20 years old, but I don't even want a Mercedes. You get what I'm saying? But I always thought they were so nice when I see them on the road, and they are nice. That doesn't mean that I want it. And so when you see people that are successful and they're posting on like LinkedIn or on Facebook saying, I'm so proud to announce this promotion, I'm so proud to announce that I got this position, like, that's great for them. Be happy for them. But you really don't know their financial situation. You really don't know their success level. You really don't know their happiness. They can tell you they're happy until they're blue in the face. But how many people in this world are actually happy? The goal that we need to reach for is happiness. And the way that we get there is by looking at ourselves compared to ourselves, looking in the mirror that is your only competition. My uncle told me that so long ago, and I will never, ever, ever forget that. Shout out to Uncle Brandon, but that's a fact. And it wasn't even saying it like a cocky thing, like there's no one in this world that can compete with you. It's like, no, your only competition that you should ever worry about yourself. Are you doing better than you were doing yesterday? Are you doing better than you were doing last year? It's been a new year, right? It's 2023 now. Am I in a better spot than I was in last year? If I am, I'm winning. Compare yourself financially to yourself, not to someone else, not to your neighbor, not to your friend, not to, you know, that person you met at the family function that wanted to have a pissing contest about who was more successful and who had the better degree and, you know, who didn't even go to school and still became a millionaire or still is making six figures a year, whatever the case is. At family events, the one thing I can honestly say is people really flex and bend the truth like a lot to make it seem like they're more successful than they really are, just because they feel like they have something to prove. Me, I don't have anything to prove to anybody except for myself. And I stand on that, and it will always be like that. And that's what pushes me to keep doing what I'm doing, because I'm not worried about someone else to give me the green light to do what they feel like I'm supposed to do. I'm the one who gives myself the green light. I'm the one who says, okay, this, I accomplished this, this, and this. Now I'm gonna write a book. Okay, wrote a book, now I'm going to write a second book. Okay, did that, now I'm going to write, now I'm going to have a course. You know, things of that nature. And, you know, if you strive for stuff like financial security and you don't want to stress, that's a good place to start. You know, I had $1,000 saved last year. How much money do I have saved this year? That's how you want to think about it with yourself, right? And there was one time when I first got started, I was in a grocery store. I saw somebody's receipt that they left at the ATM, and it said like how much they had in their checking and how much they had in their savings. And their checking account had like $10,000 in it. Their savings had like another $2,000 in it. And I'm thinking to myself like, man, what am I doing wrong? Like, I don't have that much. Keep in mind, it's like my first or second month, like, having a full-time job, living on my own. I didn't have a spouse, so it wasn't like a dual-income household, making a salary of between $60,000 and $70,000 for my first year that I started working. Like, I was holding myself to other people's standards. And then I was beating myself up for not having achieved what other people have achieved without knowing their story, without knowing how they truly are financially. All I can judge it off of is what position they have at work, or if their receipt just so happens to have their checking and savings up there. But I don't know their story. And I just had to realize I had to put in that work for myself. I had to put in the work. I had to want to do it. I couldn't just always look to other people for inspiration. Yeah, that's great to do, but you can kind of run into a bunch of rabbit holes where you're just like, well, this person didn't have to do this, so why should I have to do it? You know what I mean? If it works for you to get up at 6 a.m. and get a morning routine down and then go to work and then, you know, start a side business, if that worked, that's what I did. But that may not work for everybody. So hearing my story may help you understand your story better or help you figure out an idea of what you would want to do. But it's not necessarily going to be, okay, this is the exact formula for you. Like, no, that would be comparing yourself to a YouTuber, just like I was comparing myself back then to YouTubers. And even though they had a solid business model, even though they had a solid way to create income for yourself without having to rely on a full-time job, that's not going to be the path for everybody. The more realistic path would be to be successful at a skill and build on that skill set and just keep going and keep, you know, making more money at work and things like that. And if you want to start your own business, you can, but that's not going to be for every single person in the world. Not everybody in the world is going to get to a point where they're hitting the six-figure salary. So that shouldn't always be like what your goal is going to be. Now, if that is your goal, that's great and you can 100% achieve it. But I don't think everybody in the world should expect to make a six-figure salary. Instead, what I think everybody should expect themselves to do is to, one, compare themselves to themselves, and two, figure out a number that would be a great number for them and their families. And if it happens to be six figures or over, absolutely 100% go for it. But don't just say freaking six figures just because everybody and their mom says, I want to make six figures. That's what my goal is, to make six figures. Why do you want that? Well, it'll pay for my bills and it'll do this and I can provide for my family. Okay, well, what type of six figures are we talking about? Are we talking about 100,000 flat? Are we talking about 120? Are we talking about 150? Are we talking about 250? Are we talking about a half mil? Like, what are we talking? So don't say six figures. Give yourself a specific number of how much you want to make. And then every single year over year, month over month, compare where you are to where you want to be and keep striving to get there. Keep building on to your skills. Keep working hard. Keep working smart. But comparing yourself to others, reading books, listening to podcasts, these things can work against you to a point where you listen to a podcast and you hear someone else's success to the point where you feel like you're doing something. You might read a book with a bunch of ideas and you may not have had the ideas at first, and now you have a bunch of ideas just zooming in your head. It may feel like you're actually doing something. Then you talk to your best friend or your family members about the things that you're going to do. I don't want to hear about what you're going to do. Just do it. And then let everybody find out later. Because that's what I did when I wrote my first book. It's called The Wealth Journey. I didn't tell nobody about it. One day I just started writing it. I did at one point say I would like to write a book, but I never said what the book was, what it was about, how long it was going to be, or anything. One day I just let me write this book, man. And I wrote the book. And it didn't take long. I spent about 2 hours a day on it. And compared to where I was just a few months from then, I was like, wow. A few months ago, I was thinking about it. Now I've actually done it. So now I'm winning. Does that make sense? So just do the things that you know you need to do and you will get exactly where you need to get to. You'll be able to get to $120,000 a year. You'll be able to get to $10,000, $12,000 a month, $20,000 a month. There's nobody that's going to hold you back but yourself. But if you keep comparing yourself to others, what's going to happen is you're going to get discouraged because you're going to feel like they have it easier than you. And they may or may not, but probably not. And you just didn't put the work in yet. And the way you get rewarded in this world and in this lifetime is putting in the work, being a good person, and learning and improving every single day. You absolutely have to do all of those things at once. That's what you get rewarded for. Being a good person keeps healthy relationships amongst people. Continuously working hard despite how you feel is going to keep money consistently coming in. So you're not one of those poor work ethic having people talking about I don't feel like going to work today. And then you call off of work like half the week, every single week, then wondering why your money ain't up. That's why. And then continuously learning and improving is going to make you more valuable to other people. And even if your current company doesn't see it, another company will. And either way, you will then be entitled to more money at some capacity or another. I'm telling you these things because I've done them and they 100% work. But one thing that I do not do anymore that I used to do so much is compare myself to others financially. I don't know their grind. I don't know their story. I don't know their life. All I know is what I see on social media. I don't even really go on social media like that for that very reason, because it's better if I produce and make meaningful content for people that can then apply the advice that I give and make their lives better than for me to just spend hours a day on Instagram looking at the luxurious lifestyles that may not even be the person's lifestyle. It may just be a staged thing. I'd rather be valuable and purposeful than to be lost in someone else's lifestyle. So just think about that the next time you start to compare yourself to others financially. I hope this helps. Anyway, that's the video for today. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Reggie Bryant, and this channel is all about personal finance and personal growth so you can control you, control your finances, and control your life. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.